me see you.
Let me hear you do. Don't affect just you. Oh, I can't help but feel like I don't give a fuck. I just take the shit and blow it up. Someone I feel stuck. For what's that you pay? What you claim? We all come from the same. Not a month and a change. Do you know what makes this world go round?
Saying, get money and fuck these hoes. Where we learn these values, I do not know what to tell you. I'm just trying to find a reason not to go out every evening. I need someone that'll help me think of someone besides myself. I need someone I lead through the front door with. Cause we don't wanna hide no more. Rushing not shy no more. Neither of us wanna play the side no more. No, I'm not alone. Even though nothing was the same. Let me get your ass alone. Let me make you say my name, say my name.
Say my name, say my name.
If no one is around you,
say baby, I love you.
If you ain't running game, say my name, say my name. You like it kind of shady.
How long we got? We got 6 more minutes. 6 more minutes, and we're about to get up in here. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, we starting early with the block shit today. We starting early with the block game today. Block, 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 walk, 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 walk. I'm blocking the shit out of anybody today. Stop playing with me. Stop playing with me. Like, do y'all speak to y'all mothers like that? Do you want somebody to talk to your daughter like that? Get your dumb ass on somewhere. And that's one thing with men I don't understand. Y'all treat women and talk to women in ways that if a man talks to your daughter like that, you fucking smack them in the mouth. I be having that same energy. I don't talk to men how I wouldn't want no woman to talk to my son. Because the moment she talked to my son like that, bitch, you're going to find yourself in the wall. You dig what I'm saying? So the fact that y'all talk to women like that, I'd hate to see how your daughters get treated. Ooh. Ooh. That's disgusting. Ooh. God. I would hate to see how you protect your daughter.
Hold up.
I just, ooh. I would hate that. Like, are you proud? If you ever want to trip a man up, bring up his kids. Like, bring up, like, his, like, how he would want his kids to be treated. You want to catch a man in some shit? Bring that up. If they get upset, ooh, seems like you wouldn't want that, huh? Yeah. How many minutes we got? 2 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes and we're going to go ahead and get started. We're going to go ahead and get started. So first, we are in verse. We're going to be in verse. I know we in John. We're in John 1. You got a new apartment, we can go get you some plaques. John 1:5. Thank you. Thank you. We're in John 1:5. Child. We're gonna start in John. And then we're gonna get to the cards. Because the cards is everything that John has said. Watch this. Watch this smoke. How long have you been? All right, you one more minute. I get the point. I can hear you loud and clear. Oh, shit. And looky, 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 looky. the pattern too. We're gonna talk about that. We're gonna talk about two things already. All right. Welcome to Daily Glitter. Happy Saturday. Hola, ¿cómo estás? All right, so boom. John 1. So John 1, first of all, if you've been seeing ones. Oh, first of all, if you subscribe to my texting app and you subscribe to the third tier, your monthly update is being updated as we speak. It's being uploaded to YouTube. So you'll receive your link today as soon as it gets on YouTube. Okay? So John 1 says, in the beginning, the word already existed. The word was what was with God. And the word was God. From the very beginning, the word was with God. Through him, God made all things. Not one thing in all certain was made without him. The word was the source of life. And this life brought life light to people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has never put it out. The darkness has never put it out. Mm-hmm. Here we go. God sent his messenger, a man named John, who came to tell people about the light so that all should hear the message and believe. He himself was not the light. He came to tell people about the light. This was the real light, the light that comes into the world and shines on all people. The word was in the world, and though God made the world through him, yet the world did not recognize him. He came to his own country, but his own people did not receive him. Some, however, did receive him and believed in him. So he gave them the right to become God's children. They did not become God's children by natural means. That is, by being born as the children of a human father, God himself was their father. The word became a human being and full of grace and truth lived among us. We saw his glory, the glory which he received as the Father's only son. John spoke about him. He cried out, "This is the one I was talking about when I said he comes after me, but he is greater than I am because he existed before I was born. Out of the fullness of his grace, he has blessed us all, giving us one blessing after another. God gave the law through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God, the only Son who is the same as God and is at the Father's side. He has made him known." Very interessante, okay? Why is it interessante? It's because the full moon in Aries was not too long ago, a week ago, this week. I don't know. Doesn't matter. But the light that has been, the lights really are getting shut off, if y'all want me to be honest. The lights ain't getting turned on. The lights is getting shut off. And since the main source lights are getting shut off, everybody that actually has an internal lamp, that's what's being brightened. It's like a glow stick. That's what's happening right now. It's really a glow stick. And due to the fact that the energy, due to people basically starting to like be a glow stick. So how you make a glow stick work is you break it so it can glow, or you shake it, or you have to do something in order for the light to actually get brighter. And, or like, you know, you have to warm it up, or just something you have to do to make it brighter. And that's the energy that I'm getting, because we have a lunar, solar, something eclipse. And when an eclipse happens is when the sun and the moon, they meet. So therefore, it's like complete darkness. Now, I don't know the difference between a lunar and solar, like off the top of my head. But the fact that it's happening on a new moon, and the first card that we got was... the energy is gaining momentum. A new start is coming. New moon. And then expect powerful change. New moon eclipse. The full moon that just passed, as I told Aries like forever ago, that they have to remain in alignment. And then the card on the bottom of the deck is surrender to the divine full moon. Now, that energy was for you to be brave and courageous and be open and transparent and kind of see how you want to see yourself as. But at the same time, it was for you to ask for the things that you truly wanted. And like, you know, so if you had to open your mouth and ask for it, you had to make open space and make room for you to actually receive what you want. See what I'm saying? You see what I'm saying? And since you basically have made room to release all the things that would have held you back from getting what you truly want, now there seems to be enough room to get what you like, to receive those things, right? And the only reason why this is happening is because there has been a really big thing about sacrifice. And what we've learned over the course of the last 10 and a half months, that we've learned that people will sacrifice anything, child. They will sacrifice you, your children, their own mindset, their children, everybody. They'll sacrifice anything for their own benefit. And then we've also learned that sacrificing the things that no longer serve you actually rewards you with what you were looking for in the first place, okay? And what I feel like is a lot of the seeds that people have planted over the course of the last like 6.5 months, they're about to sprout through the world, sprout through the ground, just like she did. And only reason why they are sprouting through the ground is because you are sprouting through the ground. You are sprouting through the whatchacallit. So as we are all creating this rainbow, rainbows are what the rainbows are created from the sun after rain. Then plants are sprouted? Plants sprout after they've received water, after rainfall of water. So we've been talking about water being one of the strongest elements right now. And thank you for confirmation. Water being one of the strongest elements that we've been talking about, and also air. So with water and air, there's emotions and there's logic. So in order for you to honestly have a very beneficial like growth sprout, is that you have to logically think what's going to help the growth sprout and what's going to hinder the growth sprout. The emotional part of it is how much nurturing are you going to do? How much investing are you going to do? So logically, for a plant to grow, you know that it would need sunlight, it would need water, it would need to be planted in the correct soil, it would need to be all packed in and pouched in and all types of shit like that, right? Do I have any moderators in here? Before I finish, because the likes don't match the people or the timing that we've been in here. So I need my moderators to be watching people that are very non-reactive and block them. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. And, oh, cool, Rashonda's in here. I thought Ray was in here, but you know what I'm saying. Like, just make sure y'all are watching people as I'm talking. Because I've already had to block somebody already. But anywho, here we go. And now that everybody's decided to become a gardener for themselves, we're now realizing that you becoming a gardener and a farmer for yourself and fertilizing things and packing it into things and logically knowing, like, if you literally sit there and watch a plant every single fucking day, you're not going to see all the growth that happens underneath the ground. Because, you know, they say, you know, like a seed got to get planted. Look, like this. And the hands are the nurturing energy. So the seed has to get planted. And then it got to, like, move down and you know, down in the soil. And it got to gather its roots. And after it gathers its roots, then it got to find its tree trunk. And after it, you know, finds the tree trunk or whatever, then the tree trunk just be growing. And then from the tree trunk be growing. Then, you know what I'm saying, they got to actually, the tree trunk got to grow. And then the branches got to grow. Then the leaves got to grow. Oh, you driving? Okay, no worries. Then the leaves got to grow. And then when the leaves got to grow, you know, then the product can grow. Then when a product grow, it got to grow bigger. It's all that type of things that take time. Over the course of the 10 months, your growth within yourself has had to take, it's taken time. So when I see these two cards come out first of sacrifice, and then I see prosperity begins, and it's the root chakra. And since Saturday is considered a new week, last week, last Saturday till yesterday, Friday, was clearing out the root chakra. Then what was so crazy is the two cards that come out, shit, my bad. The two cards that come out after prosperity begins is stand your ground and accelerated motion. The thing that I already see is the fact of this is shaped like a man and this is a woman. It's funny how the man is sitting there standing on ground and the woman is literally looking up at the stars. Now, as people would say, it's a woman's thing to be very fairy tale-ish and very, you know what I'm saying, like all types of in the stars and that's a woman's thing, right? And then a men's will be physical because we're more spiritual. Now, the funny part about it is that both these cards are purple, which is the crown chakra, right? Now, this is where things get so juicy. Because next week, this week, Saturday to next Friday, I feel like things are finally about to sprout. Well, no, not sprout. Blossom. And it's funny that they're blossoming in the midst of, the autumn, right before it gets cold. So, you know, right before an animal has to hibernate, you know, they eat a lot. That's exactly what's happening in the world. The energy is being eaten up so you can harvest. So all the apples and the pumpkins. And it's funny how like this week I saw a lot of people doing apple picking and pumpkin patches and stuff like that. But like, do pumpkins grow year round? Does anybody know that? I don't know. That came to mind. So, that's not what it was that they were saying. They were saying the fact of that things have their own season. Apples are the only thing you probably can get year-round, I think, but they have a season, you know what I'm saying? Like, things, all fruits and stuff have a season. You wouldn't get a watermelon in the middle of the winter time, okay? So it says, this card comes at a time when you're being tested and challenged. There may be fierce competition or potential rivals surrounding you in your personal business life, but know that you have the strength and inner courage to stand your ground. No matter how hard things may appear, don't surrender and give up the control you have. Be brave and stay true to your core life values and belief system, which are your best allies and will help you move forward. It's important to remain clear and focused for you may have to stand alone and defend your convictions to the end. Maintain your health and stay strong so that you have an ample supply of energy to endure anything, as this could be a long process, yet ultimately a hard won victory, right? So it's funny that stand your ground comes first at 7. And 7 is endings. And if you saw 717, that was endings to new beginnings, to luck. If you saw 818, that was like the path to an abundant mindset, okay? So it was more like 8 new beginnings, and then it was like intuition, and then it was abundance. Another number that I have been seeing was 404, 505, any type of thing of crossing over, like they were happening in stages. Another number that's been popping up a lot is, of course, 1111 and 111. That's like probably one of the normal numbers we constantly see all the time, but that's what's happening. There has been a countdown to things, so therefore people have probably been seeing 3, 2, 1. If you've been seeing things of 1, 2, 3, 4, that's because the energy has been building momentum. So 1, 2, 3, things have been going up. So therefore it's like, it's been steps for you to get to the top. 3, 2, 1 has been steps for you basically to, prepare for landing. All these different things mean somewhat of the same mindset. I mean, not the same mindset, have the same concept right now. So normally before you might have seen 1, 2, 3, 4 and it was like, oh, the steps or whatever. But as of right now, a lot of those things are happening that way, is because you're now, the end result is happening to where it was. To where you're supposed to go. And the fact of that, a lot of you guys have been killing codependency, mind, body, and soul. There has been a codependent energy that has been holding a lot of you guys back, that has been a complete projection from others to yourself. There has been a codependency generational curse that has been on you literally from generations to generations to generations. It has been a generational curse to be codependent on things. So the last of the residue of your codependency is the reason why a lot of us have been feeling, and I include myself in this as well, a lot of us have been feeling a lot of emotions and not really sure what the emotions are. Like, I've been trying to tell y'all, I've been really feeling like to explain how I feel, I don't know. If somebody was to ask me to explain how I feel, I don't know. I don't know. I don't know how I feel. I'm not upset. I'm not sad. I'm not angry. I don't know. I don't know. I don't know. And I'm not going to pinpoint emotions on myself that I don't necessarily feel. So I'm not going to take the fact that I've been crying as, oh my God, I'm so sad. I'm so sad. I'm so sad, because I'm not sad. That I don't know what's wrong, honestly. But what I'm realizing is since water is one of the strongest elements of releasing, whether if it's a shower, whether if it's a bath, you know, whatever the fuck it is, water is the strongest element of the world. And what I realized is there was a lot of blockages that were happening, that exchange that I was saying that was happening between the sacral chakra and the root chakra, the tears of whatever was holding it up to go down to the root chakra that was coming down from the crown chakra was released through tears. So when I had salty tears, I realized that them salty tears was because of somebody else's codependent projections. So another thing that was coming up that I saw across my TL is people having the realizations about their mother, and the realization about their mother was them finally having this realization of that's it. Another realization that a lot of people have had is the father wound that they've been taking on or whatever has also been released. And the quickest way that those things have been released, because one thing I do see is it's not that healing hasn't taken place. The reason why I feel that this is all being released through tears is because the healing has taken place enough for you to acknowledge where the problem is. So now the healing after acknowledgement for you to build yourself up to a certain point has gone into effect, or has been in effect. Thank you. Has been in effect. So all the weird feelings and emotions that you've been feeling now are honestly projections that have been coming from either past lives that you're like right now. I don't feel like a lot of us are clearing out present moment things. I feel like the things that we are clearing out have restrictions on our present moment. I hope that makes sense. There's a lot of things that were restricting your present moment. And that's probably been like the number one issue across the board of everybody, is that's a generational curse to be in the present moment. And I talked about that last week because I was like, I couldn't put my finger on exactly what it was or why I felt that way, that there was a shift going on. But it made sense because of the fact of, if you can't be in the present moment, baby, you're not going to be able to stand 10 toes down about nothing. Because being in the present moment gives you a place of stability. It gives you a place of honoring yourself and patience and like gratitude of the whole process. Instead of you feeling like you got to skip steps and jump here and jump there. It also stops with comparing people, what they got going on to what you got going on. It just stops a lot of things that are just very unnecessary. Not being in the present moment allows you to receive unnecessary energy that's not for you. And you can't release it until you can acknowledge why you are in the present moment. So I realized that after, when I was crying, I was like, I don't even know why I'm crying, but I'm having all these emotions come up, I guess. You know what I'm saying? Like, clearly if I'm crying, it's because something needs to be released. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, you just don't be crying for no reason. And if I don't feel like I'm sad, or I don't feel like something, clearly this ain't got nothing to do with me. Because if the root chakra is the stability, and there was this stagnancy between the exchange of the energy to go from the sacral chakra to the root chakra, and from the root chakra to the sacral chakra to be released, then this is something. If I'm crying, that means that there's something of that stagnancy is being released. And what I'm realizing is it don't got nothing to do with me. It don't got nothing to do with me. Because it says the acceleration card, and it's funny that all the purple cards are of the spirit, I think. That's why I've been trying to tell everybody, make sure you stand your ground about what you feel and what you already know. That's why today when I woke up, I'm not gonna cap. When I woke up today after I had took a bath last night, a very, 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 very cleansing bath. I took a bath last night, and when I woke up today, like, I just had this, like, burst of energy to get up and, like, you know, put my little hair up in a cute little ponytail. And, you know, saying, like, before I did, like, I went outside, got some sun, because y'all know I am one brown skin girl that sits in the sun to get more brown, okay? Just one tone of sexy brown. It just does something to my spirit, okay? And what I feel like is, it was very grounding for me to go sit in the sun, because as I'm sitting in the sun, it's making me realize that all the overthinking and all the negative thoughts that I had were all stemming from a feeling from somebody else that I've had from somebody of the past. So, okay, now that I can acknowledge that these emotions are nothing to do with me, they don't match anything that I've been saying about myself, they don't match anything that I felt about myself, now, okay, this ain't my thoughts, now I can release the what's not mine. A lot of people are having a hard time not being able to release what's not theirs because it seems so real and it seems so like logical, but not really. Like, it don't seem logical in the sense of where it resonates with you. It seems like it's a logical thing for somebody else. Like, let's say somebody else is having a conversation with themselves about an interaction that y'all had, and they're trying to make it seem like, oh, you were being disrespectful, you were being inconsiderate of their feelings. And whole time, they were deflecting from the situation where they were actually being inconsiderate of your feelings. They were being disrespectful of your feelings. That's the battle. That's what's happening, is a lot of the energy that's being released. When you release energy, it now sends it back to whoever the original sender is. And since a lot of this energy is being sent back to the original person, they trying to fight it. So therefore, that's this tug of war that we've been playing with people to be like, I'm releasing this because it doesn't resonate with me. Then it go back to the person that it is. And they're like, well, this ain't mine. I can't believe they did this. And they said this. And no, that, you know what? Fuck them. Fuck this. Fuck that. And it's like, why are you projecting so hard? Why are you deflecting? Why are you running away from the original issue of what the truth is? Why are you running from the truth? I think that's like my biggest question to people right now. Why are you running from the truth? That's why I said the holidays is going to be real fucking interesting, because not only is it going to bring groups of people together, it's also going to bring people in where they're feeling that, like, you know, that homey energy, that energy of just like where the holidays bring all that love and bliss and happiness. It's really going to have them to be like, damn, I really fucked up. Yeah. Like, yeah, you really have something like wrong with you. You really are like, you really are not mentally stable, emotionally stable. Like, yeah, you're fucking ridiculous. Okay? Because, hold on. All the purple cards are spiritual. Yes. Okay, so accelerated motion. This truth represents speed, flight, swift movement, hope, passion, and all of the above. Endings to delays. The conditions around you are perfect and appear to be rapidly heading in the direction of your goals and desires. Luck is on your side, and your enthusiasm is at an all-time high. Brace yourself as you finally witness the manifestation of what you worked for and visualized. And it's funny that yesterday we got the giraffe, which was visualization. This is a call for initiative, but you should ask yourself, is there anything else in my life that I need to act on? Be wise and take advantage of these ideal conditions. Now isn't the time to fight against the river of life, the truth. Have faith and go with the flow. This strong current is taking you to a positive outcome and future, the water of the emotions of how you feel. Because the fact that the heart chakra comes out last after all this sacrificing and after all this energy that we got, it gives me what's happening is, all right, here we go. This is why I feel like this. Here we go. The downloads that was coming down, they were coming down. They made it all the way down to the feelings, and then people weren't trying to take ownership of the feelings. And then it was trying to get to the root chakra, you know what I'm saying, about what was the real stable thing to do. And then those emotions that was coming up, you know what I'm saying, they felt it in the sacral chakra. It kind of made them feel some type of way. They can't figure out why it make them feel some type of way. Then it's in the stomach. They feel it in their gut that they ain't shit. Ooh, they feel it in their gut. Ooh, I feel it in my stomach. Now that shit hitting in the chest. Now that shit hitting them in the chest. It's hitting them in the chest. So since people, hold on. We back. People was really trying to stand their ground at the fact of that they wasn't wrong about a situation. People was really trying to stand their ground that they did the right thing or they handled it in the right way. People was literally standing 10 toes down by that. And God was like, let's go ahead and help that out. Swoop. Took their feet from right up under them. Swoop. The rug from right up under them for them to fall in the water. And what's crazy is I seen this video on TikTok today, and it was this family after a wedding that all the family just decided to jump in the pool. I felt that them jumping in the pool was, and everybody jumped in the pool. Everybody, all the guests, the aunties, the mom of the bride, the grandma of the bride, they jumped in the pool. Excuse me. And I feel like that's everybody in the 11th house that we've been working on the entire Libra season. They all done jumped in a pool of emotions because we about to go into Scorpio season. They feel it in their chest. I told y'all people was going to be like, people in Libra season was like, so why y'all say y'all not friends again? So why y'all stop talking again? So why y'all broke up again? Because I thought you said that they did this, and I thought you said they was mentally ill, and I thought you said that. So, like, okay, what happened again? Just tell me exactly what happened. Because they were lying. They felt it so much in their chest that they was not wrong. In their stomach, I mean, in their gut, which was a masculine energy of the ego. And the ego has been going through a dark night of the soul. People felt it so hard in their motherfucking gut of what their truth was. And since they feeling that shit in their chest, you know where the next stop is? So whatever comes out their mouth after this point, after this week, I just want you to know it's because their heart is full of coal. Whatever comes out people's mouth after this week, their heart is full of coal. That's why they act like that, okay? Because we got two cards indicating new moon energy. And since the new moon is not next week, it's the week after next, the new moon is going to really show you that people's mind, body, and soul are sure in the wrong place. And why do I say that? Because of this. From the tarot, the five cards we got on the left side. It's funny that on the feminine side, we got one card on the right side, the masculine side, which was the King of Wands. It says inspiration, charismatic, and innovative, right? Boom. What we got on the feminine side was the Queen of Swords, the Seven of Swords, the Ace of Swords, the Four of Wands, to the Queen of Cups. See, this is what has happened over the course of Libra season. Where people found logic in their dishonesty and they found comfortability in their dishonesty, the Lord always saw who was the one being dishonest. And the fact that this tells me that There is this inner, example. Y'all see this little boy, how he dragging his sword now, and him dragging his sword, how he got his head down. There was a energetic walk of shame that people are doing or they have done. There is this walk of shame that they have done or that they are doing energetically, because you didn't think nobody saw you stealing these apples while this child was asleep? In the most vulnerable state you get, if the child was awake and the fact that she has a sword, if the child was awake, you would have never did that shit. And even though you see all six of these swords sitting right here, you still find your way to cross over the sword and steal the apples from that child. And once again, this is feminine energy. This is that divine mother, earth mother saying, I was watching you. So there's this walk of shame that a lot of people did. And what I feel like is there are some people that it was a walk of shame, and where others, it was, you know, you just finally coming into your, you were finally coming into who you were supposed to be, because it says adjustments right here, communication. See, this goes two ways. There was a walk of shame and there was a walk of honor. Thank you, Spirit. A walk of shame and a walk of honor. Those that walk the walk of shame are now very, they feel stupid. They feel stupid. I think that's the only way I can explain it. They feel stupid because they were so, like, they stood 10 toes down in how they felt. Like the way that they, and that's that Mars and Gemini. That's why I call Gemini simple-minded. Because if you got twins and you, both your twins ain't on the same accord, that means that you're only paying attention to one twin. You dig what I'm saying? And that just gives me simple-minded. Mars being in Gemini had people very simple-minded. It's funny because at the beginning of the live, I was saying, I was like, you know, a way to get a man to get his shit together, tell him, be like, do you talk to your daughter like that? Would you like a daughter to, would you like somebody to talk to your daughter like that? That kills their ego. Like, oh, right. Because now I'm testing your fatherhood that you're a dummy. Making them feel stupid. Same thing with women. You would let a woman talk to your son like that? Ooh. Ooh, that's a little bit spicy, don't you think? That's not cute. You see what I'm saying? And the fact that this is just not, it's not helping people. It's not helping them. You see what I'm saying? Simple-minded. Gemini energy this last 3 months has shown people how simple-minded they are. And with their simple-minded behavior, has made them try to play victim. And I think I said that for Libra season, like people that try to manipulate, it's gonna be firsthand embarrassment. Cause you're gonna try to play the victim and people are gonna realize you're the villain. What the fuck was that? I don't know. But you're going to play victim. And then this is why you're going to feel very stupid, because people that were walking the path of honor instead of the walk of honor instead of the walk of shame, they're now in union and they're balanced and they're in the Queen of Cups, so where they have their crown and it's being honored. It's being rewarded. It's being acknowledged. It's being seen. It's being gifted. Like, however the fuck you want to say that it's been, it's that. So when somebody's in a Queen of Cups energy, they're very loving, giving, and psychic. A lot of people are in this energy in reverse. Still trying to emotionally manipulate. Still trying to, you know what I'm saying? Oh my, well no, and no, and no, and no. Oh no. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. And that's very embarrassing, because as we go into Sagittarius season, Sagittarius is all about opportunists. As we go into that season, people are going to see that you really just, you need to seek assistance and you need to seek therapy and to feel comfortable in that type of mentality just shows how delusional you are. And it's funny that, the Queen of Cups in reverse, she's restriction, she's delusional, and she's over emotional. You see what I'm saying? Over-emotional and very delusional, you know? Very delusional. Very delusional. And it says, a lack of spiritual fulfillment has left you craving deeper meaning and connection. Bottled up emotions are in danger of bursting, leaving you constantly frustrated and overwhelmed. Feelings may be considered weakness in your upbringing, and as a result, you can feel uncomfortable with being vulnerable. Living in a fantasy has you glassy-eyed with unrealistic expectations. Mood swings and manipulative behavior keep you at a safe distance, where the Queen of Cups reverse can rule with the range of rage and ignorance. Other people's emotions feed off of you to where you bring... No, hold on. Other people's emotions feed off you to where you being to take them as your own. Create healthy boundaries and learn to listen to what you truly feel, not projections. Protect your magic. You are the queen of emotions. A lot of people are realizing that. And one thing about a queen of cups in reverse, she's very envious. She's very envious. That's the sacral chakra. That's an unhealed sacral chakra, envy. That's why that envy keep coming up. That's why people just been trying to manipulate the energy, and it's just been so crazy. The masculine energy has all this inspiration, and the fact that the masculine energy has all this inspiration is what has caused this Four of Wands. Has allowed the feminine energy to have a safe space to be vulnerable and open and transparent. And you know what I'm saying? Like, thank you for confirmation. Hold on. Like I've been saying, I don't know why I have felt, you know what I'm saying, why I have started crying. But one thing I haven't done is told myself, oh, you're being overly sensitive. Oh, you crying for no reason. Oh, I can't believe that. Why you just doing the most. Oh. Like, I haven't said that to myself. I haven't made myself feel crazy to be like, oh, this is crazy. You crying over nothing and all this shit. No, I've said, I don't know what's wrong with me. And I'm not going to sit here and try to blame myself for how I feel. All I'm going to do is acknowledge what I feel. And what I feel is I don't fucking know. And I'm also going to feel comfortable and open with myself to allow myself to not know what the fuck is wrong with me. If something needs to be released, I just need to open myself up and trust that whatever needs to be released is being released. You see what I'm saying? I don't need to be trying to play 100,000 questions with myself about why am I crying. You dig what I'm saying? Like, motherfuckers just don't cry for no reason, you know? And instead of me overthinking it about why I'm crying, I'm having this honest and patient session with myself to say, okay, why are we crying? What are we feeling? Asking myself questions to explain. And it's funny because it's 3:22 on the clock on my oven clock. I don't know. 3:22 seems very significant. It's giving me the fact of, it's just like, if you don't know why you're crying, like, you remember when with kids, if you ever was crying, your parents would be like, I'm gonna give you something to cry about. Like, bitch, go fucking heal, okay? And this is what I mean, because the dreamer was on the bottom of the deck with the little girl. That nurturing. And it's funny that the dog is right there for loyalty of your masculine energy. Being loyal to yourself. There's a sense of disloyalty that's going around right now. People aren't even being loyal to themselves and what they feel and how they treat people. And you know what I'm saying? Like, how they handle situations. They aren't even being honest and truthful with themselves. And then they expect for people to believe in how malicious and weird they are. Like, what the fuck? You don't even trust in yourself or why you feel like that. And then you want to sit there and have all these different emotions towards people. And you don't even know why you feel like that your damn self. And that's a lot of people's problem right now. Since the energy is being returned back to them, since you don't know what's wrong, even though spirit knows what's wrong, they are having this thing of just like, it's like you... You want to project so much energy onto me for me to feel the projection, but bitch, you don't even know why you feel like that. So no, we both ain't gonna be emotionally confused. You're gonna be the only one confused, because whatever you're projecting over here don't even fucking resonate with me. So therefore, you the only one that's confused. You the only one that's going through them fucking struggles and mindsets. And I do not care. Okay, you are by yourself. That is a you problem. People cannot figure out why they are having these issues and emotions towards you, towards the situation. You know what I'm saying? Like, so then if you can't figure out why you have all these emotions and shit towards me and shit like that, then it clearly means that you got a problem. You got a problem within yourself or why that? You dig what I'm saying? Like, that's a problem within you. That ain't got nothing to do with me. Like, come on now. Stop that shit. Stop that. And that's the energy that I feel that's being eliminated. Because today's pattern says emotional awareness. It says, today we may experience Today you may experience a sudden mental shift in your inner world. It is possible to gain new perspectives on recent experiences now. The intention of this is there's an influence encouraging you and others around you. There are others around you to expand your awareness of your emotional realm. Emotional. The intention is to help you look at your experiences in a non-judgmental way. Being able to openly talk about the issues of the past can make space for your psychological integration. This is also a good time to reflect on how open your heart is to relating to other people. Come on now. The key takeaway says, during this time, if you're still holding on to defensive behaviors, you may find that you're being triggered. This is intentional. The goal is to become more aware of the reality of your emotional experiences. Being in denial can prevent you from making positive changes in your life. Well, that'll do it, bitch. That will fucking do it. Because what? Hold on. Okay. Well, you know what? Just hold on. There we go. Oh, no. Okay. Whatever. Additionally, at this time, you may realize that you or others around you might be projecting your emotions on other people. During this time, you may ask yourself, how can I take responsibility for my feelings? And how can I communicate my emotional boundaries with those around me? And this will be from today all the way up until, today the 15th, today's Saturday, Sunday's the 16th, Monday, and Monday's the 17th, which is the moon, which is the emotions. That's why I say next week is going to be amazing. Well, for some and others not, because of the fact of you're going to have to take the walk of shame. And, you know, the walk of shame is not even to embarrass you. The walk of shame is for you to actually be enlightened on why you feel the way you do so you can go to healing. Because as other people's things are landing, everybody's landing to go to different places. So like some people, like I said, they're landing to go to the next gate so they can go and take off to where they need to take off to. Others are landing to go to the central station so they can start their healing. This is all a process to make sure everybody is becoming to be the best version of themselves. So it's all about perspective of how you see it. You can see it as karma and that, you know what I'm saying, somebody is wishing bad upon you, or you could take ownership that you're a shitty person. Or you could take this as an enlightening time for you to embrace the changes and embrace the solitude that you will be in so you can come out to be a better person. But my thing is, if you're going to play victim in this situation as God is trying to make you a better person, then you deserve everything that you're fucking going through to fight against it. You want to fight against it that bad, then you deserve to go through everything that you're going through. Because that is the goal in life, is to become a better person and to enjoy the human experience without it being stressful and without it being hard, without it being all this devilish energy. Like, who the fuck lives a human experience envious? Who the fuck lives a human experience weird, sad, unhappy, unsuccessful? That's very ugly of you, okay? And that makes you ugly. I just want to let you know. That makes you very ugly, okay? Mind, body, and soul makes you very ugly. Okay. And if we are just in this environment right now where we are embracing ourselves and embrace, like, I keep saying, like, you just not that girl. And a lot of people are taking that like, how everybody sees. No, you should feel like you're that girl by yourself. And if you need external validation to be made, to be seen as that girl, then you're not that girl. You don't have enough confidence to stand 10 toes down by your damn self? How can you call yourself that girl? You don't have enough confidence to mess with men that actually like you? You're not that girl. You don't have the confidence to mess with women that actually like you instead of preying on women? You're not that guy. You're not it. You're not the it factor that you think you are. Sorry to rain on your parade, but you're not it. And there's nothing that you can prove to me that you are it, because everything that I see that makes you that person all comes from external things. There's nothing inside of you that makes me see that you're that person. Because inside, your heart is cold. You can tell by the way you treat people, by the way you talk to people. I can tell by the way you fucking act towards yourself. You're not that. You're not it. It's not that. It's not cute. It's a mind thing. And your mindset is fucking disgusting and very unattractive. So how can you honestly and truthfully stand around, walk around this world with your nose tooted up, and mentally you're an idiot. Emotionally, you're an idiot. Yeah, no. Find somebody else to play with, not me. Mental stability is extremely important at this time, because the way your spirit is moving, you would need to have mental stability to have physical stability. Because if you don't have any mental stability, how are you going to be able to weather any storm? If you don't have mental stability, how are you going to be able to succeed in everything you need to do? Mental instability is probably our biggest reason for death in our community. Because you spend so much time mentally focusing on things that are not even your concern. The highlight of Libra season, I must say, is unnecessary. That has been the highlighted word, I feel. That was very unnecessary of you. That was very unnecessary for you to say that. That was very unnecessary for you to do that. That was very unnecessary. And I think people are not really understanding the root of their unnecessary behavior. Because if you did that, and that was so unnecessary, and at the beginning of Virgo season, I told you there was nothing that people were going to do. And I mean, at the beginning of Virgo season, when Mercury was in Libra, there was nothing that people were going to do without a reason. So therefore, you did that for a reason. So what was the reason? Since today is Saturn day, and we're a week away. Wait, no. Are we a week away? Hold on. The number for this week is going to be 222. Any type of 2s. 1122, 222, 122, 320. Anything with 2s. That's going to be the number of this week. Saturn goes direct either on the 22nd or the 23rd. I can't remember. Thank you for confirmation. That's going to be the highlight. That's going to be the highlight. That's going to be the highlight. Because, come on now. It's just stop it. Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. And a lot of people are going to be shocked about what's going to happen is because there's a lot of things that people did in the third quarter that their fourth quarter is a reflection of what they did in the third quarter. And they're not going to be too happy about that. You know why? Because it's funny that in my box, in my little basket of my cards, these two cards was poking out, was showing as I was shuffling, the Ace of Swords and the Eight of Pentacles. Then the card that was left in there that was like face that way, the Sun. The Truth, the Clarity, the Victory, and the Eight of Pentacles. What the Sword and the Eight of Pentacles and the Sun is going to illuminate, it's going to illuminate what you actually were working on. It's also going to illuminate how much work you have done on yourself, how much work you put in on trying to avoid healing, how much work. It's going to show all the work that you did in the third quarter real soon. Because Libra season was partially September and also October. Scorpio season is fully in the fourth quarter. So the first couple of weeks in Libra season in October, I mean, in October, not Libra season, sorry. The first couple of weeks in Libra, I mean, October was to clear out a lot of the, like, to kind of do the audit of all the things that happened in the third quarter. You know what I'm saying? Like, just kind of, that's why I said Libra season really hasn't been that bad. It just was perspective, because it, to me, just seemed like an audit. Like, it just seemed like they was adding up this and trying to make sure this and, you know, trying to, like, just do the audit of third quarter. You know, make sure all the books were balanced. Thank you, Spirit. Make sure all the books were balanced. And since they were trying to make sure that all the books were balanced, now that we finally get into the fourth quarter, like, fully into it, it was like it gave me bookkeeping and it gave me predictions of the fourth quarter. And these predictions were based off a spiritual perspective instead of a physical perspective. Now that they have cleared the spiritual perspective, and now we're going to move into the higher self energy. For one, if you feel comfortable going into Scorpio season, like if you feel comfortable receiving your soul, you should have no problem right now. If your soul is calling you to do things and you feel uncomfortable doing them, you're probably not there yet. And there has to be some work that needs to be done. And that's fine. Everybody's at different levels. But for the people that are honestly and truthfully avoiding what their soul has been telling them to do, mind, body, and soul, you're going to have a very hard time in Scorpio season. A very hard time. And you trying to play victim in Scorpio season isn't going to work, because Scorpio season is going to be about the higher self. People are seeing your spirit for what it truly is. So it's not really a mistake. It's not really like there's nothing contradicting this energy. There won't be any contradictions in Scorpio season. Where there are contradictions, trust me, whoever needs to be the one to take the accountability, it will be shown. You know, as much as people like to say, oh, I can peep that bad vibes, I can peep that bad vibes. Fuck you peeping a bad vibe. Have you ever seen somebody with a bad energy, with a dark cloud over them? Have you physically seen somebody with a dark cloud over them? They just look like they just, Lord. I don't care how pretty they are. I don't care how successful they are. If you've ever seen somebody with a dark cloud over them, it is not a pretty sight. When you look into their eyes, they look sad. When they hug you, it feels cold. When they try to smile and laugh and shit like that, you don't get that warm feeling of just comfortability, comfort, nurturing, caring. You don't get that. When you look at them, they look like they are soulless. Y'all are going to see more walking zombies. You know what else I've been seeing? I've been seeing people with this virtual thing. What is that? The VR thing? You know, where the virtual reality where they play the game. I've been seeing a lot of people playing that virtual game, and they've been playing and killing zombies. That's how people are about to look. That's how we're about to look. And it's funny that today that I put my glasses on, because y'all know I'm actually supposed to wear glasses and I don't wear glasses. Mind your business. And it's funny that today I put my glasses on, and it's just like the vision of like the goggles of seeing everything clearly. The metaverse. Well, I don't know about the metaverse. I just know about the virtual gaming and the zombies. But yeah, that's all I had to say today. So, you know, go and put the little goggles on that God will be giving y'all today, because God's giving y'all these goggles. He's giving y'all goggles. Ooh, my ear itching. He's giving y'all goggles for y'all to see everything very clearly. That's why the Ace of Swords is here. The logic. You're going to see it very, very, very clearly. And the thing about it is, you're about to see specifically what people were working on. Something about things that people were working on, mind, body, and soul, that just are really going to have y'all like, damn. And it's funny because it took so long, but in reality, did it? Because Aries, Taurus, Gemini, thank you for confirmation. Aries, Taurus, Gemini, Cancer, Leo, Virgo, Libra, Scorpio. Yeah, we going to the 8th house. Y'all about to see what people have been working on since Aries season. Since the beginning of the astrological calendar. You guys are about to see that. And, you know, I think the amount of work that people have been putting on, the energy that they've been putting on to hinder you, to help you, to hate you. Damn. I think it's mind-boggling. I think that's something that I don't want to see that shit, because that shit mind-boggling to me. That shit mind-boggling, and they keep saying it's mind-boggling. That's why I told y'all, you gonna find out shit you already knew. Don't need to do the most. Let it go. Let it go, 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 let it go. Cause it is mind-boggling. It is mind-boggling. Hold on. Angel number 129, that number just popped up. Only reason why you're finding out about it now is because of the fact that people's consequences have to be shown in front of people. That's the only reason why you're finding out about it now. Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up. Angel number 129 is an indication that divine realm wants to reward you with all the richness and wealth you deserve. 129 is a humanitarian vibration, and your angels ask you to look of how you can service the humanity through servicing others. . 129 brings into your life the positive energies associated with the root number 3: faith, trust, devotion. Damn. That's why yesterday I posted on my virtual diary. I said, if any of y'all haven't done any cleanses, y'all should have did a cleanse last night. If you felt called to do a cleanse, drink tea or something type of thing last night, it was for a reason. And it's funny because I actually started my virtual diary trying to show y'all like what I put in my bath. And they was like, no, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. I was like, yeah, y'all, I'm finna take a bath. And this is what I'm about to put in my bath. And like, I had like all the little products on there and everything. They was like, no, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Delete that shit. All right. So I couldn't post it. The original virtual diary that I did yesterday was not the one that I posted. They was like, no, ma'am, you better not post that. You better not post that. I was like, okay. Okay. I 100% understand. So if you did a cleanse yesterday or you felt called to do a cleanse yesterday, then you're about to find out why. You're about to find out why. And not like you about to find out why in like a bad way. No. Some of you guys, it is not a healthy way. But others of you, you're going to find out. Like, you've opened yourself up to receive. That's all it is. You've opened yourself up to receive. And that has been the biggest thing. But that was the clearing of whatever the fuck people were projecting yesterday. I mean, all last week, all those emotions that people were projecting, that cleared out a lot of that shit yesterday. If you feel called to do a cleanse, and this was something that you had to internally feel called to do. Like, this ain't something that I was going to advise y'all to do or anything like that. Like, I told you, I was like, if you felt called to do it, and I posted it at 10:10 last night. If you felt called to do it, then I would advise that you go ahead and do it. And then earlier this week, we was talking about different rituals and stuff like that. And, you know, like the same thing with Coach Dion or whatever his name is, Coach Sanderson, I don't know. Coach Dion, the way he walk around, like this week started off about us talking about rituals. One of the lives that I did this week, which live was it? No detours. That live that I did, no detours, that was a live about rituals and shit like that. Like, this week started off about rituals. So if you know you do any rituals, or like any type of rituals are being like brought up on your TL, or just like just something, it seemed like your soul is calling you to do it, do it. It's a reason for it. And a lot of the reason is because room is being made. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, this baseball player, they tried to say he had like a substance on his ear. Or they tried to say he had something, like, cause his speed was getting up so much. So his stats were going up so much. So like the speed of his ball, the way he pitched and shit like that. They was trying to say the man had some substance on his ear. And they was like rolling the clip back to seeing him like wipe his ear and like all these type of things. Like, it was just weird. Like, what the fuck? Like, what? Like, oh, he putting some type of substance on the ball, and he taking some type of this and some type of that. They literally stopped the game and did a whole investigation of the man's whole body. Did an investigation of the man's whole body. Talking about he was doing some type of ritual and some type of this. That's another thing that a lot of you guys might find out, or y'all might not find out. A lot of y'all might find out that people were literally trying to say that you were doing different types of things to get what you got. And that was a lie. The exposure of the world is bigger than what we think. Every single day, more things will continue to get exposed. The truth will be, and especially now that Scorpio season's here, when Mercury gets into Scorpio, Jesus Christ, the way people are going to be caught up in so many lies, it's going to be like, well, damn. Damn. You really be fucking lying. I told y'all, Aries, God was going to show his work through Aries. So anybody that has Aries in their chart and they are in alignment, God's going to show his work through you. Anybody that has opened their heart up to accepting God maneuver you through Jupiter and Aries, God going to show his work through you. So that's why family was going to ask you, how you got money to do this. Family was going to ask you why you didn't want to work that job no more. Why you think you all that. Bitch, do I think I'm all that, or do you think that because of the fact that I'm doing the shit that you wish you could, because you wished on it and you could have did it. Yeah. Yeah, so. Ciao. And I keep telling y'all, welcome to death row. And I don't think people understand what death row is. Hold on, we about to look up the definition of death row. Just for the people in the back. A prison block or section for prisoners sentenced to death. Well, you know, life happens, and, you know, that's all I can say is life happens. Life happens. And I'm not laughing at people. I'm more laughing at the fact that it's just like, you gotta be smarter than that. Like, you really got to be smarter than that. Like, shit that's too easy don't, you know, shit that seemed too easy always seemed to ring an alarm in my head. Shit that seemed to be too easy seemed to ring an alarm in my head. Especially if it seemed too easy without information. Like, something not right about that, because it's lacking information. It seems a little, there seems to still be some unanswered, you know, I'm still confused. I'm still really confused at how we got this here, you know? And what I'm realizing is that's exactly what we're about to see. That not everything glitters is gold. Sometimes it's just a path to light up to the dumbest decision you've ever made. Sometimes it's just the path you need to you know. Damn. You gotta be more quicker than that, my boy. It ain't worth it. It's just not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Well, that was the daily glitter for today. And I just want to make sure I came on here and told you that. Because, y'all, this week, honestly, for those that are in alignment, you feel like this is going to highlight who God's favorites are. What's up? Or do you just feel like in general? I don't know. Well, please prepare yourself. Please go cleanse yourself, cleanse your space, cleanse your areas. Just cleanse. This week needs to be all about cleansing. Throw away clothes. Throw away everything. You know what I'm saying? Like, this gives me new beginnings. You know, like, if you've been feeling called to cut your hair, cut your hair. Or go to somebody to cut your hair. Excuse me. You know, your hair hold energy. Cut your hair. If you've been feeling the need to throw out old makeup, old clothes, all this stuff, do it. This, because the root chakra has been, since the root chakra has been worked on this entire week, a lot of you guys should feel more stable in your decisions that you want to make next week. So, just do it. You know, one thing I want to tell y'all is, don't worry about money. Like, I didn't mean it like that. Don't try to do something to, don't try to take the cheaper way out of something. Like, just pay the money that it costs to get it done. I don't know why I need to tell y'all that, but just pay the money that it costs to get it done. Don't try to be cheap so you can save money. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if there's a cheaper way to do it, then just do the cheaper way. But don't openly try to pick the cheaper way to do something to save money. Like, y'all know what I mean. If you know it costs the extra to get this done, like, don't be like, oh, well, I'll do it. You know what I'm saying? So it can cost less. Like, don't do that. That's something that they want me to tell y'all. And they've also told me that my damn self. So I'm passing that message along because I had that moment of where, like, well, you know, I'll just do it. And they was like, and I've been trying to figure out, like, why haven't I moved forward into doing it? And they like, because you trying to find a cheap way out instead of just paying to get that shit done. And it's like, oh. Yeah, I just wanted to remind y'all about that, and I think that's it. So, I will see y'all tonight if I come on tonight, but if not, then I'll see y'all tomorrow.